Hi, I'm Eva from Budget Dutchy. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I want to talk about how I would use every dollar the YNAB way. I personally use YNAB, but it is a paid subscription of $50 a year. And every dollar is free to use. It has a few disadvantages, but if you are not willing to pay for the for YNAB, this is a possibility, figuring out how I would use systems, how I would work around the possibilities within a system is kind of a hobby for me. So I was thinking about how I would use every dollar if I had to, and this is what I came up with, and I hope that it is beneficial for someone. If you are using YNAB, they want you to only budget what you already have received. And so for now, I don't have put in any income here. And in YNAB, they want you to budget starting with the balances on your checking and saving account, the money you have available at that moment. So all those dollars should get a job to do, not only your projected income. And what I did starting this month, this is just the first month I had left available for me in every dollar, is I made my categories and my budget lines, and I made everything a fund. So everything will roll over into the next month, and that is key to how I thought about how I would use every dollar, excuse me. And to budget the YNAB way, the first thing I'm going to do is put in my balance of my checking accounts, and let's say that is at this moment $400, and my balance for my savings account at this moment is $1,000, and this moment is the 4th of October, so there are a couple of bills I already have paid. As you can see, I from every line item, I put in how much I pay personally and at what date of the month I do that. So now I have $1,400 left to budget, and this $1,000, let's say I just finished baby step one, and that that this is my emergency fund all filled up. Then I only have $400 left to budget. And as you can see, I can't fill up everything I have to pay for the rest of the month with that. What I'm going to do with that $400 is I'm going to think about when my next paycheck is going to be. And in this example, in October, I'm going to pretend that I get a paycheck every Friday. And in the month of November, and that this month is October, I know it says here November, but today is the 4th of October. So I'm going to pretend that this is October, and then that December is the month of November. And that in October I get paid every Friday, and in November I get paid every other week. Also on Friday, so that my next paycheck is going to be on the 6th of October. And then I can see that for my needs, I have already paid my rent, water and heating on the 1st, my health insurance on the 1st, and my liability insurance on the 1st. My checking account, I have two paychecks after the 6th of October to fill up this amount. And this amount, and this is what Dave Ramsey uses as a sinking fund. But everything in this category, in this budget, is a sinking fund. This, but this is the normal sinking fund. What I do need in the couple days, let's say that I do have a filled up kitchen, but I do need a couple of things, milk and produce or something like that, and that I had to fill up, going to fill up my car. And this one I have paid. This one I can wait for my paycheck of the 6th of October, but I don't want to wait. If a paycheck is late, then I don't want to have any problems. So I'm going to fill up this one now. And these ones I'm going to wait just a bit, just to see how much I have left to budget and if I have more to fill up there. Luxuries is at the end, and I'm going to pretend that I don't have any debt at this moment. And that's just because I want to make the budgeting more clear. If I go and look at what I have for the normal sinking funds and the bills I have left to budget for later in the month, then I'm going to budget a couple of bills further ahead. And this is 35, and I still have this amount left to budget. And then I will budget this one. And let's say that this one I'm going to budget later in the month, but that I want to start funding my sinking funds. And yes, I will fund this one, and I will fund this one, and this one. And that I, for my car maintenance, I will put in the rest of my available money at the moment. And then let's say it is the 6th of October and I have received the 6th, and I have received my normal paycheck of $400, and that I get paid every single week. Then I have again now $400 left to budget, and I will fill up my groceries a bit more because I want to have 200 a month. So I will now put in 100, and then you see that here is subtracted 80 because I already had 20 budgeted in this line item. I will fund my gym membership and my car tax. Oh. And this way you can start filling up your budget as you go. And when you put in transactions, for example, I went to the grocery store and I paid $80. and I paid my internet. Then this amount is again $0. But I still have money left to budget, and I will fill up my gas and parking for the whole month, and I will start filling up my technology and my home improvements. And I keep doing this. And then the rest goes to a new car. When I get my second paycheck of the month, and that is on the 13th of October, and again for 400, you can see now that I can fund most of my normal bills. I can fund my total groceries. I can fund, gas and parking was already funded, and these ones are filled up. But now I'm going to look forward until the next month, because I have to pay water and heating on the first of the month. I only have 300 left to budget, but I'm going to put that whole 300 into rent, water and heating. I still have enough for all the groceries I'm going to need, and for gas and parking I'm going to need. And these bills are already covered. So I can start putting in money into the budget for the rent and heating. For next month, then I have my 20th, and my 27th. Okay, now I can budget the whole amount for my rent. I can fund my whole amount for my health insurance, and I did it again. And my liability insurance, and these ones are already funded. Then I have my car insurance. And then I can start looking further ahead. If I want to, in November I'm going to pretend that I get two paychecks, one on the 3rd of November and one on the 17th of November. But me personally, I only get paid once at the 25th of the month. So I could start. If I want to get a full month ahead, I could start doubling this amount so that I have $26 left for the next month to pay. And if I will put in these ones I already paid in October, so these ones are funded for November. But let's say that I paid these bills. And for clothes that I bought a couple of things, but I still have a bit of money left over. And this one I'm just going to fill up. And that for miscellaneous I had spent 20. And for entertainment I have spent 30. What you will see now is that I have here now a red number, a negative number, because I have overspent in this month. What I see the most people on YouTube do with every dollar is that at the end of the month they reconcile their budget. And for example, they would change this amount to 20 here and 30 here. Just to make this zero at the end of the month. That is a possibility. I personally like to see these red numbers because I have put here the amount I need in a month. I would see it if I put here 30, that it's more than I had put in here. But I like to see if I go back, I like to see where I overspent, and I like to see those red numbers as a warning sign to show me where I went wrong. Now I have still 157.47 left to budget. And what I'm going to do is put it into my car replacement fund, just for the heck of it. And I'm not that great at calculating in my head, so I'm going to need my calculator. And I could use, I could zero it out and then put in the whole amount. But if you want to, for example, double this as I first did with the internet, but you don't want to put in the entire amount, then I would just use the calculator to figure that number out. Okay, and now I have give every dollar I gained in October, all these dollars also have a job to do. I have an every dollar budget at the end of October, but some of these amounts are going to be rolled over into November because they have to be paid at 1st of November and I get paid at the 3rd of November. So if I go here now to December, and as I said in the beginning, this is the month of for November, just because I used the first budget that was available to me. Then you will see that it just copied everything I did in October. And I don't want that, because my balance is now not anymore an income. I already put that in October, so I have to delete this. I'm also going to delete all my other income because I don't already have received it. And this is one of the things why I don't like that every dollar also copies the planned amounts. I don't want to plan an emergency fund budget anymore because I already have the 1,000 remaining. I don't want to budget anything at this moment because I don't have received anything in November at this moment. So I'm just going to be zeroing everything out. And now it's the 1st of the month, the 1st of November, and I want to pay my rent, water and heating. No problem, because I have that money remaining in what I have available. So I'm going to put in a transaction for the 7.79 cents. And then you will see that I have paid my rent for November, and that this again is now $0. And that I didn't put in yet anything to budget for this. Same goes for health insurance. And you get the ID for the rest of my categories. If I put in my income for the third. I'm sorry, I'm not sure what the correct letter combination is for 3rd. 3rd of November. Okay. And then I get now 800 because I get paid only 2 times a month. At the 3rd and 17th of November. So now I have 800 left to budget and I already have this number. So I'm going to budget my groceries for the month. I'm going to budget the gas and parking for the month. I'm going to start funding everything I have to pay until the 17th when I get my next paycheck. And in my case, that's only cell phone. And for me personally, if I fill up my budget, I'm going to fill up my needs first. So I have 5.26 left to budget, and I would like to fund this starting in rent, water and heating. And then when I get the paid on the 17th, again 800, then I can fill up the rest. I can fund this in its totality. I can fund health insurance for the next month. And I did it again. In YNAB you have an undo button. And I'm really missing that now. I'm going to fund this one. And this one. This one. And this one. And then I'm going to fund my bills for the next month. These sinking funds I will wait a bit because I also have my luxuries, and for miscellaneous I want to be able to spend 30 a month, but I still have $10 left to budget left to use from previous month. So what I can do is put in 20 here so that I have again remaining $30. For entertainment, I want to be able to use 20 a month, and so I have to put in 30 to get to the 20 remaining. And instead of reconciling my budget, my previous budget, at the end of the month, I personally like to do this so that I still see the red numbers in October, and that in November I will correct the amount that I overspent or underspent in the previous month. And now I have 155 left to budget. And then I will look, okay, what sinking funds do I need to budget or to fill up? And my car maintenance, I don't drive a lot. So I only have planned maintenance once a year, as long as nothing breaks down. But that's going to be coming up in May, so I'm going to fund this in its entirety. And then I again have everything available to me to pay for the first of the month in December, even if I get paid later in the month. For me, if I had to use every dollar, I would use this. The couple of disadvantages I talked about are mainly that in YNAB you have a reports function so that you can see what you have done over the whole year, and you can set up goals so that you can work towards and that you can quick budget. And I don't mind paying for a program that worked so well for me. I hope that this video is helpful for anyone that wants to try YNAB but isn't willing to pay for it. This is a possibility to use every dollar the YNAB way. If you have any questions, please leave them down in the comments below. I personally like comments just to know who watches my videos, and I will reply to you as soon as possible. Thank you for watching, and until next time. Bye bye.